Hello and welcome to the 29th Universiade and to the Radiga Cross Country Complex just outside Krasnoyarsk. The sprint competition is well underway on an overcast day. Quite a few powerful chemicals used in the waxing of the skis, and sometimes the technicians have a mask on to protect themselves, but what's really going on is assessing the conditions, the temperature, the snow.
The Canadians are silly.
And making sure that you get the right combination of wax for the day's conditions, which, as you can see right there, it's fairly mild, minus one. The women's semi-finals. Kushkova, Polina Nekrasova, Vesla Lototcha, Shuri Yokohama get the race underway. In the light blue, and the favourite, Petra Hintsikova. Tends to be at or near the front in her races. She doesn't like to muck around with anything too tactical, too strategic. She'll go out hard, and going out harder though, in 15 is Nekrasova of the Russian Federation. And she and Klementova of Slovakia will lead them out of the stadium. And she'll have to settle into third or fourth position, Hintsikova of the Czech Republic. So it's only half an hour or so since they were racing, some of these athletes. Sprint distance is not only about sprinting ability, but to some degree, their resilience and stamina, because they've got to race, if they make the final, four times in the space of a few hours. Hintsikova trying to force her way into third position. There's a bit of a red wall in front of her, and at the front at the moment, it's Klementova of Slovakia. Working quite efficiently, and in 15 is Nekrasova, Polina Nekrasova, in the middle of your screen for the Russian Federation. And then in one, Hintsikova. Some great noises coming from out on the course from the team support and coaches. This is going to be a very tight go. It tends to happen that the semi-finals are tighter than the quarters. Capturing the moment. Someone's trying to get themselves on the big screen. Someone's looking through a little one. Oh, Hintsikova has not skied a smart race to this point. She's really struggling to get up to the top three, and we know she wants to be a front runner, and she'll be starting to get anxious. What's she got left? She's still stuck in fourth and fifth position as they come into the stadium. Hintsikova in the light blue, a lot to do, and she stands up straight away and gets skating. Who can she get past? She's really making her effort now, and she comes up and forces her way into second place in the matter of 20 or 30 metres. It's still that Nekrasova in 15 leading it, but Hintsikova making her move. Swiftly also she does it as she comes around the turn in second position and looking for first. She's trying to make a bit of a statement here as they come in front of the big crowd at Radiga. And Petra Hintsikova forces her way to the front. This is the style, this is the manner where that we're used to seeing from the Czech skier. And in the end, coasts him. Well, I think we were quite right to be worried about her early in the race when she looked to be struggling to find a way through. But she's done it with sheer pace in the stadium. Yeah, she's pretty pleased with that. Ready for the second of the women's semi-finals. And this should be a good one. And number nine there, Leah Fisher in 18. That's Alisa Zhambalova. Francesca Franchi, hoping to upset the Russian domination. But Tatiana Elishina, Kristina Matsokina. And in number 12, Martina Bellini. So it's Alashina in two, Matsukina in three, Franchi of Italy in five, Fischer of Switzerland in nine, Zhambalova 18, and Bellini in 12. as they seek to leave the stadium at a pretty good pace too. Alishina wanting to lead them out in two, and Matsukina in three. The Russian Federation with a great chance here to race as something of a team with Alishina, Matsukina and Zhambalova. Italy represented by Franchi and Bellini, and there's Leah Fischer of Switzerland in bib nine in the blue strip towards the rear of the field at the moment. So it's Alishina through this first incline, taking them away from the stadium and up into the woods where it's well lit. And the athletes well familiar with the course now, having skied it not just in training, but twice already today in qualifying and quarterfinals. But it's two and three, Alishina and Matsukina, their bib numbers representing their qualifying times from the starting session. So you've got 2, 3, 5, and 9. Extraordinary, really, that you've got four of the top 10 in one semi-final. In the first, there was only two, in Tsitsova and Lechocha. So this is a very strong second six being sent out. Alishina, Matsukina, Franchi. You're going to hear the hard work going on, the sound of the skis across the snow, the hard work not just of the skiers and coaches, but of the waxing technicians who've tried to get it right for today. Quite mild for this time of year, as you've probably heard from other events. But really, we're expecting something minus 10, minus 20, but not so. We're hovering around zero at the moment. So benign conditions, and we're seeing racing to match. Into the stadium they come. Alishina, Matsukina looking to dominate as they make their way around towards the final turn and in front of an adoring crowd. They're going to be hard to stop from here. A Russian 1-2 looks on the cards, and Zhambalova will try and get amongst it. If this race is fast enough, she could get through. And at the moment, in third place, it's Francesca Franchi. But Alishina and Matsukina not to be denied here. Pushing down towards the finish, and Alishina makes it look easy as Matsukina finishes just behind her. The men's semi-finals. So they take their positions. And away we go in the first of the men's semi-finals. And it's Terentiev in one, Jusinov in six, Yakimushkin seven, Kirillov bib four, Liuft 11, and Makayelian in 16. So it's Yakimushkin who's decided he'd like to be somewhere near the front as he leads his teammate Kirillov out of the stadium. So there are three Russians in this, Terentiev, Yakimushkin, and Kirillov. Terentiev in third at the moment. I do like his chances of winning this if he chooses to. Yakimushkin, really quite a good pace on early, and at the back, Mikhailian might just be struggling to keep up this pace. You let the likes of Terentiev, Dusanov, or Yakimushkin get 10 metres ahead of you in a short race, then there's only going to be one outcome, because they've got a good finish as well. Russia, 1, 2, 3. I feel like I've said that a few times in the last few days. They have been dominant at the cross country. Nations can bring as many as 8 competitors to the competition, but can only nominate 6 for a particular race. And here is the Russian Federation, 1, 2, 3 in one semi-final. So they're having a great competition. It was expected. They are the hosts here in the Siberian city of Krasnoyarsk. 7, Yakimushkin from Terentiev has moved up to second place, and now forcing into third is Dusinov of Kazakhstan in bib number 6. So trying to upset the 1-2-3 so talked about and predicted. little bit of cat and mouse and checking and thinking as they come down now off the sweeping right-hander into the stadium. And once the fans can see them for real, and the cheer goes up, especially to see Terentyev out front for the Russian Federation. He's moving across to the left-hand side to make the left-hand turn into the home straight. And then they'll have about another 100 metres or so to ski in front of the big grandstand. And the flags are waving for their man, Terentyev. Jusinov of Kazakhstan in second position at the moment, but under threat. Just checking his rivals, Terentyev, as he makes his way down to the line. This is going to be a very tight finish. I think Terentyev got it, but second, maybe Jusinov. Well, that was close. We'll go to our second semi-final. And away they go in the second of the semi-finals. And the two Czech competitors in the light blue, Fabian Stoček in 22, Andrei Černý in 2. In 3, it's Sobakarev. And Russian hopes resting with him and Igor Kazarinov. Norway's Martin Skinstad has done amazingly well to get through to the semi-finals. He was the 26th fastest qualifier out of the morning. Stoček. Fabian Stoček in 22. As they make their way up the climb, and Bushtov in 8. 26 Skinstad. 3 Sobakarev. 23 Kazarinov. And 26 Skinstad. I'll be very interested to see what kind of form Skinstad's had after giving so much in his quarterfinal, having been really racing the event of his life to get through to this far. Well, he's not going to die wondering as he takes the lead, the Norwegian. A minute 20 into the race. But there's a few skiers around him with withering pace. Kazarinov trying to work his way to the front in 23. 3 on the inside, Sobakarov looking for a good position from him, skiing very close to the inside of the course. Quite heavy traffic, isn't it? Shoulder to shoulder, ski to ski as they come around that left-hand turn. And in 8, moving to the front, Butsov of Kazakhstan. Plenty of instruction and encouragement coming from coaches around the course. They settle into the tuck, gather themselves for the final effort. They head under the big screen and then a sharp left-hand turn into the home straight. Sobakarev leads it at the moment in 3. In 8. Oh, there's nearly a fall there from 22, which is Stoček. 8 is Butsov. Sobakarev has found what he needs as he surges to the front, around in front of the big grandstand now. And Sobakarev has the race at his mercy. They're trying to make a move on him. Černý in 2. Looms up beside him, but doesn't quite get to him. And Sobakarev, then Černý, Stoček, Skinstad, Kazarinov. So we got a women's final to bring you now. And Francesca Franchi, big smile from her. Tatiana Alešina, Kristina Matsukina, Nekrasheva. 4 Russian competitors in the final. Alisha Zhambalova is a little better over the longer distances, I think. She's just scraped through to the final. Francesca Franchi in the green for Italy. left behind a little at the start, as was Zhambalova. She's not a quick starter, Zhambalova, but she's got great endurance. Has she got the pace? She's a two-time gold medalist already. I think she might have to hand the baton over to someone else today if the Russian Federation is to get another win. But they've got four in the final, and leading them out is one of them, Tatiana Alashina. We're looking to see what kind of race is run by Hintsikova in the light blue. Petra Hintsikova, in her semi-final, looked to be in trouble in just this kind of position, back in the pack, fourth and fifth. But she is so fast over the last few hundred metres, no one could match her in a semi. But this is the final, the best of the best. And it's Alashina, Matsukina, and Zhambalova. Well, Zhambalova back in fifth position, actually, so it's now Hintsikova in fourth position. 15, Nakrasheva. So Nakrasheva is the third of the Russians at the moment. Alashina. What is the Russian team tactic here to try and deny Hintsikova of the Czech Republic? Hintsikova still sitting back in fourth position. Didn't worry her in the semi, but she's up against quicker skiers here in the final. And what she got left? Zhambalova, now she looks to be struggling, as is Franci of Italy. So I think it's between the front four, and the move needs to come reasonably soon from Hintsikova. She made it on the sweeping turn down into the stadium in the semi, and she's trying to get up alongside Nakrasheva, and they won't be making it easy for her. Into the stadium they come, just a few hundred metres to go. And where is the effort from Hintsikova? Here she comes, she stands up first, she starts skating, but she's got a long way to make up. I'm not sure if she can do it from there. She's still 4 or 5 metres behind the Russian trio of Alashina, Nakrasheva, and Matsukina. Now she's caught them. Now she moves around the outside. Here comes Hintsikova. And now she's challenging Matsukina. Hintsikova around the outside. All the fans want the Russian victory, but they may not get it as Hintsikova forges to the front. Has she got enough left to see it through? Hintsikova cruising down to the line. She's got more than enough. It is victory for the Czech. And she is delighted. She is too quick, too powerful over this distance. And I think she's happy. Well, not only is it a little piece of history for Petra Hintsikova, but she has denied the Russian Federation for the first time at Radoga in the cross country. Hintsikova wins it by almost a second from Matsukina and Nakrasheva, then Alashina, then Zhambalova. So Russia second, third, fourth and fifth, and Franci of Italy in sixth position. Ready for the start of the men's final.
Number three, Andrei Sobakarev, Russia. Number six, Aset Dusenov, Kazakhstan. Number two, Andrei Chorny, Czech Republic. And number one, Alexander Terentyev, the winner of the qualification, Russia. Number four, Ivan Kirillov, Russia.
And away they go. It's Cherny in two in the middle there in the light blue. And one is Terentyev, fastest qualifier. And it'll all be over quite quickly. And seven, Yakimushkin. I say quickly, it's been a long day for these boys because they had qualifying, quarterfinal, and semi-final. Just dropping off the pack a little, Andrei Cherny. As they make a little bit of a climb away from the stadium. You see the floodlights on around the course. Just coming up to 2 o'clock in the afternoon in Krasnoyarsk. One and seven, Terentyev and Yakimushkin. So again, four Russian athletes making it through to the final. a real tribute to the strength and depth that they bring to this skiing. And Andre Cherny, he looks like he's got nothing in the tank. He's right off the back already. So I think we can dismiss the chances of the Czech in this race. He's not even in the picture, so perhaps he's not not feeling that special. Kirillov at the back of that pack. And now the pace really on from Terentyev. He's decided to make a bit of a surge here and see who can come with him through the 900-metre mark, so 600 to go. And it is Terentyev from Yakimushkin. And Dyusinov is the Kazakhstan athlete in the blue and yellow. Yakimushkin. And in seventh, chasing Terentyev. Well, Terentyev has strung them out a little bit, but maybe reduced it to a race in four. The effort. Has stretched the field somewhat, and there's three medals up for grabs and four after them. Got to 1-7 and 3 for Russia. Terentyev, Yakimushkin and Sobakarev. So they've lost Kirillov. They've still got Dyusinov there for Kazakhstan as they come up to this last turn. And Dyusinov looking for a place here amongst the Russians as it is Yakimushkin who leads them into the straight. Yakimushkin, who's had an amazing first few days at the cross country. Is he up for another medal here? Yakimushkin, they can't catch him. He's pushing his way down to the line. And it's Russia first. What about second? Very tight between Dyusinov and Terentyev. So Yakimushkin, champion in the 10K Classic and Pursuit, is also the sprint champion. What an extraordinary athlete he is. That is three gold medals in three events for Ivan Yakimushkin. Well, there's a little bit of argy-bargy there as the stock's getting caught up with one another between Terentyev and Yakimushkin. And it's confirmation now that Ivan Yakimushkin has been disqualified. He was first across the line, but after the jury looked at the incident with Alexander Terentyev, they've given the first placing to Terentyev. So Dyusinov moves up to second position and Sobakarev third. And Yakimushkin, controversially, sensationally disqualified. Hard day's racing. And these three athletes, well rewarded.
Universal medalist.
I'll gather for the photos. And to round off a day of great sprint competition. I mentioned it takes some endurance as well as sprinting ability to get through to a final and to win it. Well done to Alexander Terentyev, Aset Dyusinov and Andrei Sobakarev, Russia and Kazakhstan. Crowd's had a good day's entertainment. I'm sure many of them will be back for more. I hope you can be too.